Hello students, welcome to NIRS Education Channel. Let us continue the lesson, A Baker from Goa. In our previous session, we came to know that still today, the old people, they recall the good old days of Portuguese and their loaves of bread. Though Portuguese people vanished from Goa, still today, bread making is very famous in Goa. Those things we have seen. Now let us continue the lesson. During our childhood in Goa, the baker used to be our friend, companion and guide. He used to come at least twice a day. Once when he set out in the morning on his selling round and then again when he returned after emptying his huge basket. Yes, during the childhood days of author, baker used to be their friend, okay, companion and guide. See here, it shows how much close relationship was there between the baker and children. He used to come at least twice a day. Once when he set out in the morning in order to sell the bread. And then again when he returned after emptying his huge basket. Mostly afternoon time or evening time, after selling all his bread, he used to come back with his empty basket. Like this, two times he used to come to in front of his house. The jingling thud of his bamboo woke us up from sleep and we ran to meet and greet him. Yes, whenever the baker, he used to come to sell, that time he used to make jingling sound of a bamboo. Okay, he used to hit bamboo stick and that used to produce a kind of sound. Hearing that sound, children, they used to wake up from sleep and they used to run to meet the baker and to greet him. Why was it so? Was it for love of the loaf? No, not at all. Then why they were running like that? Was it their love for loaf? No, not for that. The loaves were brought by some paskin or bastain, the maid servant of the house. Yes, loaves were brought by the house servant. Okay, paskin or bastain means it is a French, Portuguese word. Paskin or bastain means servants, okay, maid servants. They used to take loaves of bread. Then why children were running towards him? What we longed for were those bread bangles which we chose carefully. Sometimes it was sweet bread of special make. Actually, children, they used to run towards the baker in order to choose the bread bangle. What do you mean by bread bangle? See here. Bread bangle means cancon. Another word that is literally translated to bangle in Konkani. In Konkani language, cancon means bangle. Okay. This ring-shaped bread that is popular all over Goa. Okay. It is a ring-shaped bread that is very famous in Goa. Especially children like that very much. So in order to choose such kind of round-shaped bread, children used to run towards a baker. Sometimes those round-shaped bread used to be sweet also. So in order to choose such kind of bread, children used to run towards the baker. The baker made his musical entry on the scene with the zang zang sound of his specially made bamboo staff. Yes, he used to give entry with the zang zang sound. That sound was made by bamboo staff, bamboo stick. One hand supported the basket on his head and other banged the bamboo on the ground. Yes, his one-handed used to support the basket on his head, and in the another hand he used to make sound with the bamboo. He used to hit that bamboo to the ground, then it used to make some kind of sound. By hearing that sound, people used to come towards him. Yes, bamboo on the ground. He would greet the lady of the house with good morning and then place his basket on the vertical bamboo. Yes, he used to greet the lady of the house with good morning, and after that he used to keep that basket on the vertical bamboo. Okay, vertically he used to keep his bamboo, on that he used to keep that basket. We kids would be pushed aside with mild rebuke, and the loaves would be delivered to the servant. Yes, the children used to gather around him. That time he used to push them with mild rebuke. Rebuke means an expression of disapproval or a scold. Okay, in a mild manner he used to scold the children and he used to push them aside, and the loaves would be delivered to the servant. Then he used to give loaves of bread to the servant. But we would not give up. But children, they were not ready to give up. Okay, when the baker used to push them, they were not going to be disappointed. We would climb a bench or parapet and peep into the basket somehow. Yes, standing on a bench or standing on a parapet. Parapet means a low retaining wall. In front of the house there will be small wall structure, we call it compound wall, like that wall. Okay, standing on that, children, they used to peep into the basket. They used to see whether the bread bangles are there or not. I can still recall the typical fragrance of those loaves. Yes, many years later, writing is writing this anecdote or event. Then also he could recall or remember the typical mean regular or usual fragrance of those loaves. Okay, he could recall the fragrance of those loaves. Loaves for the elders and bangles for the children. Yes, children, they used to be attracted by the bangles, and elders, they used to buy loaves. Then we did not even care to brush our teeth or wash our mouths properly. Yeah, early morning they used to come towards the baker, and they did not even care to brush their teeth and wash their mouths properly. Okay. And why should we? Who would take the trouble of plucking the mango leaf for a toothbrush? Again, the writer is asking question here. Why should we care about washing our mouth and brushing our teeth? Okay. And why should take trouble of plucking the mango leaf? By using the mango leaf, they used to brush the teeth. So why would take the trouble of plucking the mango leaf for the toothbrush? Okay, why we have to take that trouble? That is the question of author. And why was it necessary at all? First of all, why we have to brush our teeth? Why we have to clean our mouth? What is the need of that? The tiger never brushed his teeth. In the forest, such a ferocious and strong animal like tiger, it is not going to brush its teeth. Then why we have to worry about that? That is the question of author. Hot tea could wash and clean up everything so nicely after all. Anyhow, they were about to drink hot tea, and that would clean up everything nicely. Okay, that would clean their mouth. Then they were not ready to take any separate risk in order to brush their teeth or clean their mouth. So let us stop here. We shall continue in the next session. Thank you for watching.